Zebra Technologies derives intelligence from enterprise assets so companies can make better business decisions. With barcodes, RFID, and IoT solutions, we give assets a digital voice so companies know where it is, what it is, and what condition it's in. Zebra Technologies. See more. Do more.
Welcome to the IoT Uplink, where we examine all the factors driving, influencing, and adding to the complexity of the Internet of Things movement in the manufacturing and product development marketplaces. The Internet of Things is a growing trend in the consumer world at large, but even more so, it's growing rapidly in the manufacturing space. As manufacturers continue to warm up to the idea of the Internet of Things, big data, and using the cloud, questions of security and visibility have continually emerged. In this industry, there isn't much room for error, if any, so management teams and software experts have been working to make the Internet of Things for manufacturing not only work, but are also secure while remaining highly accessible. IoT is being looked at as the ultimate connection for all manufacturing data. By using the Internet of Things, companies are increasingly able to run leaner, stay on top of maintenance and failure issues, and develop better efficiency practices.
The key to understanding what the Internet of Things can do for a company is based on the tiny numbers that quickly add up. Improving product quality management, process controls, and operations management are just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to improvements that all this data can provide. The Internet of Things provides more than just awareness of problems on the floor. It has the potential to provide insight into future problems and even preventative maintenance. In fact, a survey by The Economist said that 86% of respondents said they have a significantly increased production and quality control data for analysis, and this number is sure to grow. IoT has the potential to provide raw data and create instantly actionable information for managers and floor employees. And as the Internet of Things matures in the manufacturing space, we can only expect to see the quality, efficiency, and speed of production increase.
Joining us today is Chet Nabudri, the Director of Global Manufacturing Industries, Marketing and Business Development at Cisco. BYOD and big data are huge trends impacting manufacturing on a number of fronts. So Chet, what have you seen as some of the smartest ways that manufacturers are dealing with these trends?
You know, BYOD and big data are two very different trends, right? So they're very, very different dimensions of the use of technology and IoT, the Internet of Things, and Internet of Everything, if you will, in different ways. In the case of BYOD, which of course is bring your own device, what we see typically is that within a manufacturing environment, particularly the production environment of manufacturers, is that there's not a huge amount of adoption of allowing operators and maintenance and a lot of the folks on the floor to bring their own devices for purposes of interacting with the equipment, interacting with the processes in the manufacturing environment, the HMI SCADA and so on. However, we are seeing where there are supervisors and plant managers typically, or even executives who are visiting the plant who do want to have access dashboards and what have you via their own device. And this is where there can be security, major security concerns. In the case of big data, this is where all the proliferation of less expensive sensors and kind of the Internet of Things, if you will, is really creating more information sources. And that's all the way, kind of at the plant level where you have device layer, machine level sensors that are proliferating, in addition to other contextual information, right? So across the supply chain, you can have information on temperature, humidity, depending on what impacts the process or impacts, kind of the decision making, you can get that data typically. The problem is, how do you use it, right? And how do you tie it together with things that are going on in the rest of the plant or the rest of the supply chain? And we're just at the beginning of that, we're kind of nascent within making use of big data analytics in connection with business intelligence, right? Kind of business information systems, and bringing those together in a way that you can, one, make more real-time and better decisions, and two, you can actually automate at that grand supply chain level. Now, nobody, to my knowledge, is doing this. However, this is a target for folks.
What are some of the best ways for manufacturers to securely share all of this data?
Securely sharing the data that's coming off of the Internet of Everything, if you will, is a question around policy more so than technology. The technology is there to lock down on what policies you want to implement. And I'm not saying it's all there, there will continue to be an evolution as you know, as we proliferate again the Internet of Things. More and more devices means there's more and more reach opportunities and different security constructs that are needed for technology. However, in general, the technology is there, and so it's really around the process, people, and really policy interests that you want to structure on who gets what when.
Data visibility on the plant floor is extremely important for a number of lean initiatives. Do you think it's necessary to be sharing this information down to the level of individual devices, particularly if they're personal or mobile devices?
That level of data visibility is not only important for the for the plant manager supervisor, but as I alluded, it's also being used in conjunction with HMI SCADA systems and kind of visualization for the operator, for the maintenance, and so on. Now that's not, kind of differentiating that from BYOD. We're not at all seeing BYOD at that level. What we are seeing is what we refer to as the visual factory.
What do you feel are the most pressing issues regarding safe data sharing going forward?
Kind of on a path forward, that's the importance, is taking IT and OT, as we like to refer to it, to the folks from Cisco, we like to refer to the plant floor industrial automation as OT, operations technology, or operational technology, where taking the controls and automation engineers and the folks who are responsible for data flows and real-time control systems and all that that's going on in the plant, and really bringing them together with IT, and in this case, in concern around security and data sharing, as you put it, that cultural convergence, if you will, cultural, and in some companies we've seen where they're actually combining those organizationally. So you have kind of a manufacturing IT and a controls and automation engineering group that are reporting to the same, same individual. And so that's, I think, the most important on a path forward in terms of data sharing and the use of more and more IoT and technology within a factory environment is bringing those two together and being really integrated about how you're approaching that technology, people, process, and policy.
Thanks, Chet. That'll do it for this edition of the IoT Uplink. For Bridget Bergen, I'm Chris Fox. Thanks for joining us.